Everyone has a different story, and I'm not sure if there's anyone out there that has told the story that we have. Our story might not seem interesting to people because we didn't have to overcome some crazy spectacle or obstacle in our lives, but we want people to know that there's a different aspect of our lives that we did have to overcome. We weren't supposed to be this successful playing basketball. Both of my parents came over here when I think mom was like 16 and my dad was I think like 17 or so.
They were born and raised in Nigeria.
They came with their siblings and they stuck together, went to school, got their education, and just started building lives for themselves. That's kind of the foundation that we built our lives upon too.
We grew up in Houston, and Houston is considered Little Nigeria. There are a lot of Nigerians in Texas and a lot centralized in Houston. In Nigeria, there's three major ethnic groups. You have the Yoruba, you have the Igbo, and you have the Hausa. And we're Igbo. We're from the southeast. Igbo Kwanu, yeah. Being distinctly Igbo, we're determined, we're very resourceful, very conservative. And then you couple that with being first generation born in America, where there's resources and opportunity. That makes a powerful combination.
Growing up was fun.
We have four total sisters.
Having four different girls in our family, but then we all coexist and we all know how to take care of each other. That's like the biggest gift. We were hyperactive, this one especially, like busting holes in the walls, busting windows, all that kind of stuff. And our parents wanted to give us somewhere to channel our energy. And so eventually my parents heard that you put your kids in youth sports. And we started off in gymnastics, then we go into basketball.
I was 11 years old. I will never forget this. We were at Campbell Middle School. My mom, her good friend in the school district, gave her an AAU application and went to the school, was wearing jorts, and I was terrified. And of course, like, my coach was googly-eyed because I was like 11 years old and I was like 5'10". Chiney was intimidated and watched me play for a year.
And we weren't good at basketball when we started.
No.
We were absolutely horrible, like, and that's an understatement. I think my parents wanted to teach us was that no matter what we're doing, whether it's school, whether it's basketball, whether it's something you just started to do, do it to the best of your ability.
Because of how they instilled that fight in us, we wanted to get better and we wanted to compete and we pushed each other. We used the connection that we have as sisters to continue to play basketball, and we practiced against each other. Even if it wasn't serious, we were out on the blacktop in our driveway just shooting, playing games. I mean, we used to make fun of it. We'd be like, okay, let's play a game of basketball. It was like Nneka against the three of them. My parents were getting a lot of flack from
their contemporaries, their Nigerian peers.
Because we were playing sports. We are not the typical Nigerian, not even that Nigerian young women. The fact that we were investing so much time into a pastime instead of studying to be doctors or lawyers. And it's funny now because those same people are now asking, what do we have to do, you know?
Yeah, and putting their kids in sports.
Yeah.
Kids are getting scholarships.
Being able to represent breaking that stereotype in a successful way and also in an inspirational way is something that we form our foundation on.